Today, it's common to hear stories of innovators and whiz kids who made it big after dropping out of college. The success of these individuals might lead some to believe that dropping out isn't a big problem, but for many, it is.
Too many students invest their time and money pursuing a degree they never finish, and they frequently wind up worse off than if they'd never gone to college in the first place. Dropping out creates large costs for students and for taxpayers. For students, costs are often in the form of student debt and lost time. For taxpayers, costs are wasted public subsidies and foregone tax revenue. Some estimates show that the total costs of non-completion impose a $500 billion drag on the economy each year.
And yet, we need to be careful about how we help more students finish college. Often, top-down reforms can lead to unfortunate consequences. This got us thinking. What if educators and policymakers focused on practical ways to encourage college completion?
So what do we mean by college completion? A simple answer might be graduating. While a student can graduate after any length of time, so long as a student earns a degree, in the research, most studies count completing as finishing a four-year degree within 6 years. This is already longer than the traditional 4 years you might expect a degree program to take. It's only the students that take longer than 6 years, even if they graduate later on, who are usually counted as non-completers.
Today, only about half of students who begin college complete their degree, and completion can vary by the type of college, program length, and sector. Nonprofit four-year universities typically graduate more of their students than two-year community colleges and for-profit universities. But the variance isn't only caused by the type of college, it's also influenced by the characteristics of the students who attend them.
As you might expect, some types of students are more likely to complete college than others. Wealthy students, and those that do well on standardized tests, typically have higher college completion rates. But you might be surprised to hear that high school grades are an even stronger predictor of college success. Earning good grades requires consistent behavior over time, such as turning in homework, showing up for class, and taking quizzes. Developing these habits in high school ends up helping students throughout college. But higher ed institutions also play a role in helping students graduate.
Several practices appear to help improve a student's chance at completing college. Some schools offer targeted completion grants to juniors and seniors with unmet financial need. These grants can help students overcome stumbling blocks posed by emergency car repairs or textbook costs. They aren't silver bullet solutions, but college administrators would do well to examine programs like these at their own schools.
Administrators should also think about the ways that students actually experience college-level programs or initiatives, since they can play a large role in improving completion rates. A growing body of research tells us that some college practices and initiatives can lead students to feel like they aren't supported or they don't belong at college in the first place. With that in mind, college completion programs can be counterproductive if they send students the wrong messages. Instead, university administrators should rethink their efforts by evaluating how programs might affect a student's motives, mindsets, and other psychological factors.
Some colleges already invest in wraparound holistic support programs. One program serving 8,300 students provides extra support with financial aid, academics, and advising. While these programs can be costly to run initially, linking students' motives with academic and financial support can improve college outcomes and reduce costs in the long run.
But even before college, we know that there are concrete steps that high schools can take to help prepare students to be college ready. Imagine you're an eighth grader struggling with math. Surprisingly, you'd be more likely to succeed in high school and go to college by enrolling in a more rigorous math class, not an easier one. Another carefully designed study found that students who took a double dose of algebra in high school were more likely to enroll in college. These examples suggest that providing students greater access to advanced coursework can improve academic preparation, helping develop good study habits needed to complete college.
So there are a lot of ways we can affect college completion rates. But what could go wrong? Well, actually a lot. Policymakers ought to take extra caution to ensure that they don't accidentally encourage colleges to game the system. In the past, a single-minded focus on test scores has led to corner-cutting and manipulation in K-12 education. In higher education, some colleges already operate as diploma mills, churning out watered-down credentials with little labor market value. Creating more of these programs is not what anyone intends when thinking about increasing college completion.
As a final caveat, note that we're not suggesting that anyone should expect they'll just be handed a degree for going to college. College goers first need to put in the requisite time and work to earn that diploma.
But for those students, we know that both colleges and high schools can do more to help them get a degree. Now is the time for families, educators, and policymakers to get serious about the large dropout problem at American colleges.
To learn more about college completion, check out the link to the college completion page at AEI.org. Also, let us know what other topics you'd like AEI scholars to cover on What If, and be sure to subscribe for more videos and research from AEI.